In Egypt, the oldest examples of sailing craft go back 3,500 years before the Common Era. That was in Mesopotamia.
Yes, I've got it. You go and cut a few slices. Go on, it's from the log.
You want me to slice up a log? Why?
Just slice them. Yes.
Yeah, we can only imagine that's how it was. We can't be sure about mankind's history until written language was created. Then it's right here at about the same time that writing came into being. So from now on, we have our use of the wheel and the sail and writing. Well, children, ready to explore a little? Adventure is calling.
But, Maestro, why do people need adventures, all this exploring? Why don't they settle down, stay home?
What a dull world if there weren't any new inventions, new discoveries. Lucky for us that man's been curious from his beginning. Where would we be today if we weren't driven by desire to explore, to know about things, to discover the world? Now, back to our story. An empire is founded in Egypt on the banks of the Nile. On the island of Crete, at the heart of Europe, a great civilization is developing also. With its sailing ships, it rules the seas.
Aha, there's a Phoenician ship. Prepare for combat.
Aha, that's a Mycenaean ship. Prepare for combat.
Make away!
You make way. The seas belong to us. We are from Crete.
Sail your boat right back to Crete. Seas belong to us, Mycenaeans!
We're the kings of the oceans! The seas are for nations! Sail on!
Why didn't you stop? The seas are ours!
Now you can drink it up!
Yes, it's true. Two maritime powers rivaled Crete for mastery of the seas. The Phoenicians in what is now Lebanon, and the Mycenaeans in Greece. This rivalry was to go on for centuries, until one day, a certain thing happened. What happened was really terrible, children. It took place on Thera, one of the islands of Crete.
A heavy cargo of wine for Thera. You can't hold it. It's a very good vintage.
Well, one way to find out. Cheers.
Just to be sure, I will have one more sip.
I couldn't quite tell.
Anyway, it's good and strong.
You're right. It makes you feel the earth moving. I'll tell you.
Destroying the whole island. Tons of ash spread over thousands of miles in a wide circle. This was the end of the great Minoan civilization of Crete. The Greeks and Phoenicians were to dominate the Mediterranean Sea. They tell the story of a certain Greek named Ulysses who went on a voyage of 10 years, met all kinds of strange creatures during his adventures. A famous historian, Herodotus, says 6 centuries before our era, and the pharaoh of Egypt, Necho II, summoned a certain Phoenician captain.
I'm informed you're a courageous and skillful sailor. Would you be willing to sail down the Red Sea and go completely around the African continent and then return to the Mediterranean? Well?
Yes, sire. On one condition, the reward be equal to the mission and the danger.
To make a trip of 25,000 kilometers of unexplored route with their technology, do you realize, children? They knew almost nothing about that. The voyage lasted 3 years, we're told. A century later, it was the unbelievable voyage of Hanno, a Phoenician leaving from Carthage. Why, it's Hanno and Himilco, my two captains. Now look at my ship. It's a wreck. What in the world happened to you two?
It's those Mycenaeans. They're better armed than we are. Yes, we're just lucky we made it.
Well, come on, you'd better put some proper clothes on.
Bye, my olives, fine ripe olives.
You see?
Give me your finest fabrics for my two unfortunate captains.
Oh, it's an odd size. I'm not sure it's in stock.
Shells direct from Crete. None better for high quality walking.
Oh.
Cotton, genuine Egyptian. Please inspect my superb coats.
Go on, put some color in. That's it now, tin. No! For fraud, you put in plenty of copper, but not too much tin.
You're both presentable now, so I suppose we can sit down and have a chat. Three goblets of mead.
Hey, look at that.
Now, friends, listen. I have heard about big rivers in certain regions of Africa where the rivers are so full of gold that if you discover one or two of them, your fortune's made.
Sail our ships past the Pillars of Hercules?
Today, our name for the place is the Straits of Gibraltar. There's nothing to it, a passage running between Gibraltar and Africa.
It's dangerous.
Oh, but see, 100 dangers might come up.
These Carthaginians are self-stopping them.
They get rich.
We'll stop them.
Maybe we can be rich if we go with them.
Anybody sailing beyond the Pillars of Hercules? Crazy! Crazy! It's the end of the world!
Why have you done it?
Even Poseidon, the Lord of the Sea, wouldn't attempt that. He'd give up. Nope, the world ends and the sea spills into a deep pit. There are sea serpents. Nobody would go.
There's a many-headed hydra. The man would be crazy to fight with them. You'd have to be strong as Hercules.
Well, thinking about it, all my blood runs cold. Gives a man a thirst for a drop of mead. What about it? One cup.
Those Munzas are real, and they're dangerous.
No, there's a lot of superstitious nonsense. However, the beautiful Nereids will protect you.
That's right, these sea girls, good looking.
Yeah.
And they're dolphins. I've seen those with my own eyes. Well, him will go. What do you say?
Hanno says, let's go.
We'd be happy to be your guides for part of the way.
Done.
Well, we're on our way.
And that was that.
Maestro, why were they so scared? Was it because they were monsters or what?
Well, they thought the Earth was flat and they would come to the very brink and tumble off. Hey, dummies, we know the Earth is round.
Oh, yes, today we know that. But a Greek mathematician, the great Pythagoras, realized the Earth was a ball, but nobody would believe him.
No, look, this isn't the place. The Hercules that turns against us. We can't fight it. And if we do fight it, then we're done for.
Well, put in here and wait till the wind is favorable.
The wind is coming from that direction. That's the Zephyr. We've got to wait for the Euro in the other direction.
Changed.
Euros! Hey, the Euros is pulling! Quick! Up sails! Oarsmen!
I told you there'd be a monster! I told you the monster! Remember, remember! Oh, you'll gobble us all up the boat with us aboard! We'll end up sea monsters' breakfast! I hate it when this happens.
What monster?
The monster always returns! What did I tell you, the monster?
It's just a school of large fish, like dolphins, only bigger. They won't be any trouble for us.
Not true. They're my big waves capsize the ship, and then we'll be fish food, you'll see, you'll see.
So far, you're the only one making waves.
I don't want to be here. You take me home.
It's getting shallower, and we're approaching the sun. And if we go on, the water will begin to boil. We'll cook, or maybe we'll run aground. And on shore, there's nothing but sand. We'll shrivel up and die.
Steer clear of the coast.
Supplies.
Well, we'll be all dead from thirst, and then we'll be dead from hunger, and besides, we'll all be dead.
There's land. Look, we'll find fresh water and food right there.
Primeval forest with wild animals and savages every place. Even if we can be gobbled up. In a way, I wish I had stayed home.
Oh, hey, he looks like us. Yes, but he's black.
Before the Common Era, the Sahara was the site of prosperous pastoral civilizations. The historian Herodotus tells us that these people fought against another people, the Caramantes, nomads, who roamed over North Africa.
Yeah.
That's all.
It's gold.
Waste of time. Let's beat it. Wow!
Go, 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 shiny, 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 gold!
And with this gold, we're all rich, but Hanno wants to keep going south. We'll all be killed.
We won't go with him.
Yeah, we want the gold.
We'll take the ship and gather up as much gold as we can. Then we head straight home, and we're rich.
What about the captain?
Hanno, he takes a long swim. Now grab the ship. Give up, Hanno. You're outnumbered.
Death is how we punish mutineers, men.
You're the one who's gonna die, but we're generous, Hanno. Jump overboard, and then we'll let you swim the rest of the way.
I too am generous. I'm going to let all of you live. Since you're in a hurry to get back, I'll make you the same offer. Swim back. Tomorrow we explore.
We'd better be very careful. No telling what we'll run into out here.
Shh, look there.
Hey, wait, children.
They're not children, they must be dwarves, huh?
No, they're pygmies, I heard about them. Pygmies, humans, we're gonna be pygmies lunch, they're chopped into little pieces. I wonder if pygmies eat a lot. I suggest we all go back.
Hey, do we humans? A pig! That's more like it. It's late. I think we'd better be going. Apparently they won't permit us to leave, so now what?
Well, there's too many, so we'll wait until there's a chance to get away tonight.
No.
This is our chance!
Mission accomplished! Back we go!
Hooray! Hooray! Hooray!
At least once in my life, I was a king.
A century later, a famous Greek astronomer, Pythias, would make another voyage of discovery. Only this time, it was to the north. He encountered the Hyperboreans.
The Hyper what?
Boreans were a certain people in the north, and the Hyperboreans, well, they lived farther north.
Oh, Pythias, you going away again?
Yes, I'm going up north this time.
Go too far up north, you might freeze.
But now the days are long.
Yes, what a shame, because during the day we work. It's at night that we rest. Anyway, have a good time.
Have you noticed? The more we go north, how much longer the days are.
Yes, Pythias. I've also noticed the days are much colder. We're going much farther?
We're going to where the days are so long, there isn't going to be any night.
No night at all? You must be dreaming impossible. I mean, the sun has to set each night to come up in the morning again.
Not so. If the Earth is round, as a number of philosophers claim, then in the north, well, all summer the sun doesn't set.
Oh, those philosophers, they think too much, all of them. And summer isn't what I'd call this. Why don't we just go back home and get...
No, not yet. Look!
It's a whale! It's enormous!
The sea monster! Don't tell me those people are going to attack!
No!
I wouldn't do that. My foolish move! Yeah.
We want to sail even farther north, that way.
Thule.
I know that word. It's a land all the way to the north. You say Thule. We want to go to Thule.
Hmm. Mush, 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 mush.
What am I doing in a place like this? Well, we're all going to freeze solid and our fingers are going to turn to ice and drop. Oh, when I think about the warm days down south. Hmm. No, scared of my guest.
You see, the sun's at its lowest point. It won't set. We'll wait right here. I don't believe it. The sun is moving sideways.
You were right. Only how come it didn't set? The sun always sets.
It's really quite simple. The Earth is round like a ball. Here, where we are in the far north, the sun is level with us. It goes around, but never below the horizon. It never sets.
And so here they never see night, never see the stars.
Sure they do. Look, in winter, it's just the opposite. The sun is below. It doesn't rise. It goes back to the south below the horizon.
I wouldn't want to live far north with no sun. Look, Pythias, what do you say we go on home now? We saw Thule. Let's make it before nightfall.
All right, let's go home. Let's go! Heading back home!
A night lasting 6 months? Ha ha! Pythias! All you explorers full of tall stories. Listen, everybody! He says there are nights 6 months long! Who falls for the...
So it was, children, that many centuries before our time, they began to realize the Earth is round. And Pythias calculated quite precisely the distance he had traveled, and a century later, a wise Greek, Eratosthenes, mathematically calculated the circumference of the Earth. They began to realize that even old Herodotus didn't have all the answers when he said,
The Earth is round and surrounded by oceans, but Athens is here right at the center. To the north, it's only ice and snow inhabited by Hyperboreans, while to the east, there is Asia. It stops at the Urals and the Indies, but Africa is certainly crowded with elephants and pygmies and giraffes with very, very, very long necks,
etc. Well, it's pretty clear to see, children, that it's only the start of man's understanding. Our ancestors went a long, long way, and some of those voyages, well, we're going to go along with them.